I'm Richard Roper. Coming up next, Mark Wahlberg stars in a remake of one of the great films of the 1970s. It's my review of The Gambler right now. Perhaps the best lead performance James Caan has ever given was in the 1974 film The Gambler. It's one of the best movies ever made about the self-destructive side of gambling, and it's one of my favorite movies of all time.
Here you go, little Joe. All the way.
Now comes Mark Wahlberg in the remake, which retains many of the key plot elements, but really loses something in the translation.
You got me feeling lucky. I'm putting everything on black.
In the original, Caan's literary professor was his own worst enemy. There seemed to be something almost noble about his existential, near-suicidal approach to gambling.
I love winning, even though it never lasts.
In Rupert Wyatt's remake, Wahlberg is a literary professor named Jim Bennett. He spends nearly all of his class time berating his students and bemoaning his own fate.
The literary person in here is Miss Phillips. She is better at writing than our U.S. presently amateur number two is at tennis.
He's also cruel to his wealthy mother, who's played by Jessica Lange, and he's even a jerk to the loan sharks who are looking to get paid. This guy comes across as an entitled brat who needs to grow up. John Goodman and Michael K. Williams liven things up as loan sharks who speak like philosophers. William Monahan's screenplay does have some great monologues.
But I haven't been drunk since Reagan was president. I got a DUI and in jail, I actually fell down and pissed my pants. You don't need to do that twice. I tell you this so you'll know everybody's been there.
Everybody's been there.
And Brie Larson does a nice job as a brilliant student who's drawn to Jim even though she sees right through him. The gambling scene's just okay. There's not as much tension as there should be when Jim risks insane amounts of money on roulette and blackjack.
19 red.
What's wrong with you? You got brain damage?
And the subplot from the original in which a basketball star shaves points doesn't really ring true. Mark Wahlberg has grown enough as an actor, we can pretty much buy him as a college professor, author. There's just not enough depth to the character of Jim, and not that much of a story arc. You know a movie's in trouble when we're starting to root for the loan shark to put Jim out of his misery. I give The Gambler a C. I'm Richard Roper. You can get all my reviews at richardroper.com and at reels.com.